Hello everyone, in a new video from your channel New Cars Technology. In this video we visit the Douai factory. How is the electric Renault Megane E-Tech made? The manufacturing process of an electric car is fascinating logistics. From the repetitive micrometric gestures by robots to the meticulous maneuvers of humans, assembly responds to a well-oiled organization. We visited the Renault factory in Douai, Nord, which produces the new Megane E-Tech. The anthill adapted to electricity before embarking on a major shift towards battery production. Launched in early 2022, the Renault Megane E-Tech is the second diamond-shaped electric car produced in France. After the Flins factory, Yvelines, that produced the famous Zoe, the Douai factory, North, is now assembling the new zero-emission sedan. Spread over an area of 2.5 square kilometers, the site has produced more than 10 million vehicles since it went into service in 1970. Its 2,305 employees and hundreds of robots are busy today around Scenic, Espace and Talisman, as well as Megane E-Tech. Up to 420 electric Megane per day until the summer of 2022. If it's enough to sign a check to order an electric sedan, it's a much more complicated process to manufacture. It all starts in sheet metal, a workshop monopolized by robotic arms, dominated by the smell of heated metal. Few people move around in this spacious hangar. 98% of process is automated, to ensure constant precision and twice the execution speed of humans. 1,200 robots were tasked with connecting the 350 sheet metal parts that make up the body of the Megane E-Tech. A complete puzzle thanks to 4,000 arcs and laser welding, gluing, and screwing. These processes are relatively energy intensive. The Douai plant consumes an average of 256 megawatt-hours of electricity per day, equivalent to the consumption of approximately 21,000 households, with a maximum of 300 megawatt-hours on certain days. The body shop, whose production is synchronized with the other workshops in the factory, currently delivers 210 Megane E-Tech bodies, i.e. 30 per hour, every day. The target is to reach 420 vehicles/day by July 2022. In the assembly workshop, people preferred robots. The bodies are then sent to a second hangar, the paint shop we are not allowed to visit. This area can only be entered with certain clothing to protect yourself from fumes and prevent any ingress of dust. The vehicle really comes to life in the assembly shop, where all the parts are grafted onto the Megane E-Tech's frame. Operations performed mainly by humans, 78% male and 22% female. Only 5% of the movements are made by robots. The electric sedan also required an increase in the workforce in the assembly shop. It went from 238 to 438. Vehicles placed on conveyor belts are gradually equipped with their components, cables, windows, doors, seats, instrument panel, etc. Teams have track cars that are regularly replenished by a fleet of 500 transport robots called AGVs, automatic guided vehicle. Coming from the Renault factory in Clion, Seine-Maritime, the Megane E-Tech's engine is placed by an operator using a crane. Dedicated battery access for firefighters. In parallel, the battery is installed in a special room upstairs. 30% of the less physical, non-automated transactions are performed there by employees, especially in the case of medical restraint. The package is delivered in the form of modules, rectangular boxes containing pocket cells, from the LG factory in Wrocław, Poland. The latter is placed on the frame of the battery by a robot with suction cups. The cables, electronics boxes and liquid cooling circuit are assembled by hand. The 40% charged batteries, 40 or 60 kilowatt-hours capacity, depending on the customer's preference, are sent to the ground floor to be integrated into the vehicles. A marriage in complete secrecy, accomplished in a matter of seconds by a robot slider. The battery has a fireman access on the top face. Accessible from the ground, this metal disc allows firefighters to attach a spear to it in case of fire. It consists of a membrane that can only stretch under the pressure of water, thus filling the package. This makes it possible to contain any thermal leakage more effectively. A QR code affixed to the windshield provides rescuers with all the manufacturer's advice in the event of a fire in their vehicle. Douai plant will soon manufacture its own battery cells. Although the battery cells currently come from Poland, they will be produced there in a few years. AESC Envision will build holding a cell factory on the nearby Douai site and workshops directly. It's both an economic and environmental benefit, as the batteries will no longer have to be transported by truck. The electricity produced in France is much more carbon-free than in Poland. The production process would logically be less impactful for the climate. The first tranche, with an annual capacity of 9 GWh, i.e. 150,000 Megane E-Tech 60 kWh batteries to get an idea, will be launched, and the other two tranches are already planned.